all with great hope and joy and peace in your believing. Amen. Our message today for the Epiphany and Baptism of our Lord Jesus Christ is from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 19, verses 1 to 7, the account of John's followers seeing Paul and the baptism and faith that takes place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. set in our mind, then we trust that idea as it creates an inner good feeling. And unless someone says the narrative we've woven out in our heads, it gets us to put our back up quite readily. We trust what we know and feel, which doesn't always match up with what God knows. In that same Edmonton parish, I was a brand new candidate, 25 years old. They had a pastor they adored, 28 years, who after him followed a pastor for 5 years who they hated. Drained the church of 300 to 40. At my first voters meeting, people sat on opposite sides of the room with arms folded. Visible division. Support the other, it's us versus them. It was so deadly, so unchristian. There is only one side in the church, the gospel-centered side of Jesus Christ. But it took about 8 of those 12 years to dismantle all that toxic environment. It should be splendid creating quick unity. We pastors want to have everybody on the same team, but like all relationships, real, true, lasting unity takes time and patience and prayer and communication. Because God is the creator of unity. That is why we even have baptism, the sacraments, the creed we just said. Because that is our definition or our script of unity, if you will. Jesus died on the cross all alone to bring all believers together. Apostle Paul couldn't be in good conscience to allow any disunity in the Lord's church. Some follow Paul, some follow Apollos, some follow John, and it just can't happen that way. Disagreements, though, are healthy and common. Settling disagreements can be the part that is the hard part. It's unwise fighting against the Holy Spirit, because then we think we know better and can be angry inside because then we think, oh, God's not listening to me, so, but yet I'm still right. Well, no, the Spirit is causing that inner angst to create change. And we can trust the change. We can trust the growth will come through the constant working of the Holy Spirit with His Word. Paul wisely used the message of John that they knew to lead them to a life in Christ. And this opened up a whole new world for them. So Paul baptizes them in the name of the Lord Jesus, lays hands on them, and they receive the Holy Spirit. And the response is immediate. The gift of faith inspires tongues and prophecy. Now, tongues here means they're speaking in a heavenly dialect that wouldn't be known to the hearers. Not a foreign language, a heavenly language. Now, in a worship setting, Paul tells us a person would witness and interpret it. But they are immediately bubbling up from the fountain of life they just received. The flowing rivers of joy within their hearts. And then prophecy comes, which literally is truth-telling. They're sharing this faith in Christ. Powerfully validate the Spirit's inner work. Now, tongues and prophecy might seem odd to us 2,000 plus years later. And I know we're skeptical at times of those in our day. And Lutherans historically have love of Christ in the